Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. I'm so excited to be back. I had to take a little break from recording videos. You can probably tell why. If you follow me on social media, you already know that I had to get a nose surgery. And thank you so much for all your kind messages. I really appreciate that. And well, today I just wanted to make like a update video on what's going on and what is going to happen on 2025. So we have a lot of content coming this on 2025. We have a lot of videos, we have a lot of classes, maybe even a podcast, we'll say. And also we have a lot of experiments going on. I'm really excited and I want to share with you a little bit like a sneak peek of things that is going on. So let's start with the spicy tomatoes that we have here. We have a new media. And the spicy tomato loves them. Look at this plant. Check this out, all the way to the top of the test tube. And look at the roots. Amazing results from this new media. I'm testing still some different media variation stuff like that, plant growth regulators, but so far we have great results with this media. Another update I have here, these are the Sarracenia Flava Maxima from the Christmas video. I actually only gave away two plants, so I still have a lot of these plants. So I think I want to save them for the ones in the red media. I'm probably going to give this away on Valentine's Day. And the ones on the green media, I'll probably give this away or I'll save them for St. Patrick's Day. So I think that will be good for this. But the great thing is there is no contamination at all. Great thing, I use a PPM on them and have no contamination. So that's great. Also, not only testing spicy tomatoes media, but I'm also testing new media for houseplants. So I have experiments on different medias for houseplants. And so far they are doing very well. I mean, they've only been here for not even a week. So I'm still had to wait for longer, but I'm testing different medias for different houseplants. So a little bit more specialized media depending on the plants. So we know that monsteras like different media that they say some of the philodendrons, some sort of the alocasia. So I'm testing different medias, very excited to have the results pretty soon. And I also want to share those with you in the future. One experiment that people have been asking me updates on quite frequently is the Nepenthes. So I have Nepenthes edwardsiana seeds that I sow. These are seeds that I got that go from Jeff from Nepenthes Gut. Thank you so much from him to provide the seeds. And here are some of the results. So they still sprouting. So Nepenthes are notorious for taking a while to sprout. But so far we have some seeds or some plants that have sprouted. So you see the tiny, tiny little plants right there. We have a few more over on this side. So you haven't seen the video. Make sure to check it out. Sterilize these seeds in four different methods, and they have given me good results. The thing that I haven't given me good results is the media with charcoal. So I tested media with just regular 1/3 media with agar, and I also tested media with charcoal as well. And so far, the media with charcoal hasn't done that great. Only one seed has sprouted in the media with charcoal. So we had to wait a bit longer, so that's why I haven't really made an update video on these plants, because Nepenthes can take all the way to like 6 months to sprout. So that will be taking me a little bit longer to release a video or to make a video on those plants. Another update that I want to do is on the Alocasia Black Velvet Variegated. I will show you a biocouplers and on a live stream that I did, I took a biocoupler that have a ton of corms for the alocasias, and here are the plants. So I transferred the plants to a media with like a kind of like more kind of rooting media or like a growing media, And the plants are starting to grow some leaves, which is fantastic. Let me show you, I have a few more examples right here. This one is a pretty nice one. But you see the amount of multiplication is amazing. And also they are now starting to grow some leaves, which is amazing. But let me show you what I have done, because I'm working on a video on alocasias, well, on the black velvet variegated, to see how many I can grow using the biocoppers and the biotill system. And let me show you what is going on. This is crazy. So these are 25 all alocasia black velvet variegated. I started with a tiny amount of corms into each of the biocoppers, and this is how they look now. They are going crazy. I have so many alocasia black velvet variegated. So soon I will make a video. The idea is that I'm going to take from one biocoppler full of alocasia black velvet variegated, I'm going to transfer them into like flasks or like test tubes, most likely test tubes. Going to grow them and see how many I can get from one biocoppler. And from there, I'm going to do like a math or do a test to see how much I can potentially make from one, how much money I can make from one biocoppler, and just multiply it times 25, because that's what I have here in the biotill. And let's see how much money we can make from one biotill system in, let's say, like three months or whatever amount of time that the video is going to be. Looks like it's going to be a pretty quick, because they're already filling up pretty fast. So just a couple of more experiments that I'm working on. Just yesterday, I did, I started growing some bamboo seeds. So I got some bamboo seeds. I know some people have been asking me about growing bamboo in tissue culture. So I got some seeds. I need to look which species of bamboo this is, but it's one of the giant ones. So I never worked with a bamboo, so I hope I can got them to grow. I never sprout bamboo seeds. So I got some in tissue culture. Some other ones I want to grow in soil. And then later after they grow, I want to try to sterilize the plant and introduce it to tissue culture, because I know if I'm doing with seeds, it's usually pretty easy. But if you get the plant growing, trying to sterilize the plant, it can be a completely different thing. So I want to try both and see what works. And then after here, I want to transfer. Well, I also want to do this experiment in the biocopplers to see how fast I can get bamboo growing in tissue culture. The other seeds that I'm growing as well are lemon seeds. So I got some lemon seeds, and I'm growing these lemon seeds just because these are giant, I mean, enormous lemons. I'm going to put a picture here, but these are really big lemons that I was able to make lemonade with just one lemon, and it was pretty good. So I'm trying to grow some plants or some lemons from the seeds to see what happens. And these are kind of some of the experiments that I want to do, some kind of fun experiments. Like I grew a lemon from the grocery store, or I grew like an orange from a grocery store, or a strawberry, or like a mango, or an avocado. So those are kind of the ideas that I want to start growing in tissue culture, just kind of just for fun, some fun experiments, doing stuff like that, nothing that too serious. I obviously want to do some like more research, more like a more science-based experiments as well, but I also want to do a balance working here in between and there. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. I mean, I know this was a little different, just a little update. In the next few weeks, I want to start releasing some other videos, again, more like educational content, especially for beginners. So just kind of maybe older videos that I recorded in the past, I want to kind of revise them and record them again, and providing a little bit more content and more more value for like educational value for everybody, especially for the beginners. Now that we have a lot more subscribers, we hit 20,000 subscribers. I want to kind of make videos more dedicated to the beginners, but also a little bit more intermediate and more advanced as well. So I hope you have enjoyed it. I will see you in the next time. Goodbye.
Thanks for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested on conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.